My name is Peter Jackson. I'm currently the head of Department of Junior Secondary at our school, so I cover year 7 to 9. And the context of the class that I was teaching today was the students are in year 7. The students have a wide-ranging abilities with regards to literacy. Previously, we've looked at how the Earth, Moon and Sun move around each other. Does anyone want to help me? They've heard of the word eclipses?
Yeah.
There are all different types of eclipses, but I know two. There's the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse.
Okay. Crystal, what did you have to add?
The eclipse is where the moon comes around the Earth and is blocking the sun and the moon gets smaller.
Okay. So we'll have a look at those things today. So the 5 E's is an inquiry-based approach to science. So hooking them in, I guess, with an engage, then letting them play with things, explore things, build their own knowledge, and then we go into an explain phase, and of course afterwards there's elaborate and an evaluate. To get them to start thinking about what they're seeing and making observations, they need to explore a little bit so they can build some of that knowledge themselves before we go into a more detailed explanation. When we first started, we just did a little bit of a warm-up. So the idea behind the warm-up is to engage students and get them sort of hooked into the lesson a little bit. So we just used a quick strategy where I just used mini whiteboards and did some quick questions, and the kids write the answers on the board and flick them up at me so that I can also gauge their understanding. For some students, I may have to go back and revise a certain topic if they haven't quite got the answer with that. So remember in history we're looking at ancient Egypt?
Yeah.
So with ancient Egypt there's evidence there on coffins and drawings that eclipses were occurring then. The ancient Chinese also have stories, and they actually believed that they used to believe that a dragon would come and eat the sun and the moon. Science can contribute to the area of history, and there's a lot of crossover with things like evidence and sources. We then started using the models. So they had some questions and some activities they had to answer using their models, and I then had to work with the groups to make sure they could model for me a lunar and a solar eclipse. What happened in the solar eclipse?
It was in a line.
Yeah, it was in a line, but what was the moon doing?
It was blocking the sun.
Yeah, what was happening on the Earth? What was being cast onto the Earth?
A shadow.
So does the moon create its own light?
No.
The sun. Okay. I guess when it comes to misconceptions, if you're going to change a misconception in a student, the misconception has to be challenged. And so often the models will help in challenging that and them being able to see it, and it's different to what they were thinking. So if that misconception is challenged and they can actually realise or see that the new information is better than their own previous thoughts, they will change their misconceptions. So, can you show me a lunar eclipse? What's happening now?
We're getting light, but the moon's getting light.
Why isn't the moon getting light?
Because the Earth is blocking the moon.
Earth is blocking the moon. Blocking what to the moon, though?
Light.
And why does that?
The sun's light reflects off the moon, so we get light from the moon.
Okay. And then we moved into more of an explain area where we were using our reading strategies to pull information out from a text to explain the eclipses and how they were caused and the different types. The reading strategies we use, they're linked to a tactical reading strategies. They use a before, during and after process. So before, what we did was we used an anticipation guide. So these were just questions that are either true or false, but they're linked to the text that the students are about to read. True or false? Solar eclipses occur when the Earth blocks the light from the moon. Lunar eclipses occur when the Earth is between the sun and moon. They answer the true, false, and then after the reading they can go back and revisit their answers and change them if they have to. So when we went through the reading, we do some highlighting where the students are looking at pulling out key words, key phrases, and then from that they use the note-taking process. So they use those key words or phrases and we add some notes there. So we're looking for students to develop that ability to not just copy stuff word for word, and that builds more of an understanding of what they're reading and gets them to engage with what they're reading as opposed to just skimming through the text. So the 66-word strategy is an after strategy with your tactical reading. And so with that, the students only have 66 words to summarise the information that they found about a particular topic. So they either used the note-taking or they used annotated diagrams, and from that information they used only 66 words to summarise everything that was in the text.